this Shabbat Shira, we have a sermon in song. So we're going to invite Cantor Rosen to join us on the virtual bima. I hope we've got good tech support on that end. And cantorial soloist Lindy Rivers will continue to teach us Torah through song here in the sanctuary. Shabbat Shalom, Rosen.
Last night, I spoke about how the Israelites were only ready to recite their song of freedom and redemption after they had truly prepared for that moment. The song came to them spontaneously in joy and in harmony because they had worked so hard to reach that special day. They needed to experience all the ups and downs of their journey in order to be ready for that moment. As we just finished reciting the Shehecheyanu, we acknowledge that, Lauren, you too were ready for your moment. I regret not being able to be with you and your family in person today as I am in self-isolation. Like many of your family, friends, and community members tuning in virtually, I know how hard you have worked to be able to recite those sacred words of blessing, and they are well deserved. The Shehecheyanu blessing lifts up moments to gather sanctity as we ritualize where we have come from, where we are at this moment, and where we yet hope to journey. Along our journey, we may find ourselves stumbling and in need of support, encouragement, and guidance. Thankfully, we know we can turn to song and our liturgy in those times to tether our emotional and spiritual selves to our tradition, our community, and to God. This morning, we need these words of comfort and consolation, perhaps more than ever before. Let us now journey together as we explore the power of sacred song as a vehicle for hope and healing. Cantor Benji Ellen Schiller was supposed to be our composer in residence this Shabbat Shira in the sanctuary. And while we look forward to welcoming her sometime in the spring, we will now enjoy a virtual preview of her composition of this sacred blessing of Shehecheyanu along with our wonderful temple singers.
Baruch ata Adonai Eloheinu Melech haolam Shehecheyanu V'kiyamanu V'higiyanu L'zman hazeh. Praise to you,
our tefillot often respond to events or situations that have taken place in our daily lives and throughout history. Many of them were composed in response to what was happening in the world at a given time. As part of our evening liturgy, we recite Hashkivenu, a moving prayer asking for God's help to protect us and to spread a canopy of peace over us each and every morning. Hashkivenu is not found in our morning liturgy. Instead, this special blessing was added by our sages hundreds of years ago, prior to the days of electricity, as a response to the fears and anxieties that would come with the onset of sunset. The late Rabbi Chaim Stern, Zichrono Livracha, author of Gates of Prayer series of prayer books, composed a modern interpretation to this prayer. He alludes to the virtues of love, understanding, peace, and friendship as elements that can protect us against life storms. In this modern composition by Cantor Dan Singer and singer-songwriter Noah Aronson, these words of hope are brought to life through the power of melody and song.
And understand.
For the past several weeks, our Torah narrative has spoken about the Israelites' struggle as slaves on Egyptian soil. They were exhausted and felt defeated, fearing that there was no end in sight. Sound familiar? The text uses the term kotzer ruach as a way to describe the emotional state of the Israelites. A simple translation tells us that kotzer comes from the root meaning short and ruach meaning spirit. Rabbi Joshua Rabin reminds us that Rashi sought a deeper explanation for this kind of term. Rashi interprets the term kotzer ruach contextually and argues that if one is in anguish, their breath comes in short gasps and they cannot draw out long segments of air, implying that the Israelites were too tired after years of harsh labor to even hear what Moses was saying. Perhaps this is akin to what we today have coined COVID brain, a scientifically proven mental state, a thing which we have all experienced from time to time over the past 22 months. Nahum Sarna, a modern biblical commentator, says that kotzer ruach refers to the fact that the Israelite spirits were crushed and that it is ruach, the spiritual and psychic energy, that motivates action. The type of ruach that Sarna is referring to is similar to that which Rav Kook writes about in his work Orot HaKodesh. Here, Rav Kook speaks about kanfei ruach, the wings of spirit. He instructs us to rise above adversity, to rise up as each one of us possesses a powerful strength within. He encourages us to heed its call for the strength to turn, that it can turn against us if we don't use it properly. This beautiful melody and arrangement you are about to hear was composed by Abigail Uziel Amar, a young Israeli musician, and arranged by Toronto's own Judy Edelman Gershon. The arrangement was commissioned in honor of the Israeli Movement for Progressive Judaism's 2021 Rise for Reform fundraiser. It was performed by cantors and cantorial soloists from across Canada and Israel. A few of them may look familiar to you. Inspiration for hope can come from a variety of sources, and as Alan Middleman, a professor of Jewish thought and ethics at the Jewish Theological Seminary, points out, hope is an underappreciated virtue that must be strengthened like any other muscle. He writes, "Hope as a quality of life lived in the presence endows life with both depth and transcendence. It enhances the vertical axis of life. Hope also points towards the future. It awaits or anticipates the fulfillment of promises of God in concrete time. Hope, in this sense, moves along a horizontal axis. Our world exudes hope through our individual and collective efforts. As Professor Middleman teaches us, we must make a conscious choice to activate and exercise our ability to maintain and foster hope. And while hope remains a key ingredient on our individual and collective journeys, it often comes with a price. Struggles and setbacks are a part of life. They affect us physically, emotionally, and can sometimes be paralyzing if we let them get the better of us. Our ancestors experienced this time and time again throughout their journey in the wilderness. And so while holding on to that pillar of hope, we must allow ourselves the opportunity to heal. We must remember the things and people in our lives that bring us comfort. We must stop and take the time to be grateful for them. And most of all, we must grant ourselves permission not to be too hard on ourselves. After all, we are only human." Our final musical selection this morning is a prayer for hope and healing. It is a familiar melody to all of us, composed by Cantor Leon Schur. Its words are more poignant than ever. Its cry is crystal clear. And so before cantorial soloist Rivers leads us in song, I humbly ask God to hear this benediction for hope and healing for each and every one of us joining from our respective homes and everyone here today in the sanctuary. Dear God, we are ready for this moment of healing. Healing for ourselves, our loved ones, and healing for our fellow neighbor. We ask you for healing for our body, our souls, people everywhere, our nation, and our land. On this Shabbat Shira, our Shabbat of song, let us be reminded of our ancestors' hope in dark times, their relentless spirit and pursuit of freedom. Please heal us now, and may our song today become our beacon of hope for a brighter tomorrow. Shabbat Shalom.
Refa'enu Adonai v'nei rafeh, Hoshienu v'ru v'sheyash, El karov l'chol korav, akarov l'ireyam yisho. We pray for healing of the body. Of our people.